Bombay High Court ordered Union Environment Ministry to demolish 31-storied Adarsh Cooperative Housing Society but stayed the order for 12 weeks. It asked Maharashtra government to investigate politicians, ministers and officers involved in the scam. It gave 12 weeks time to Maharashtra government to appeal in the Supreme Court against the order. The Supreme Court has refused to change its order on NEET and asked the government to conduct the exams on 1st of May. The centre had moved the apex court seeking modification of yesterday's order to allow state governments and private colleges to hold separate entrance exams for MBBS and BDS courses for the academic year 2016-17. Gujarat government has agreed to provide reservation for economically backward classes in the general category. Families with income below 6 lakh rupees to get 10% reservation in government jobs and educational institutions. Notification to be issued on 1st May. Government has said that it is pursuing all means to bring to justice the corrupt and wrongdoers in the Augusta Westland chopper case. The matter reached the Supreme Court seeking FIR against Sonia Gandhi and other Congress leaders to be heard by the apex court next week. Special CBI court has ordered framing of criminal charges in Amarkonda Murgadangal block allocation case against industrialist Naveen Jindal, former Jharkhand Chief Minister Madhu Koda and others. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said the government is taking all necessary steps on the issue of tax evasion and notices being served on those whose names figure in the Panama paper leaks. Informing this in the Lok Sabha, Jaitley, however, said any individual case could not be discussed in the House. Government released the third set of 25 files related to Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in New Delhi today. Culture Minister Mahesh Sharma released the files at a program in the National Archives. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been invited to address a joint meeting of the US Congress during his visit to Washington in June. US Congress Speaker Paul Ryan says friendship between US and India is a pillar of stability. PM Modi will be the fifth Indian Prime Minister to address a joint meeting of the Congress and the first since 2005. India and Papua New Guinea signed several agreements, including in health, agriculture and security sectors, during President Pranab Mukherjee's two-day state visit. He paid homage to the soldiers, including many Indians killed during the Second World War while fighting along with the British forces, and laid to rest at Bomana Cemetery. President Pranab Mukherjee paid floral tributes on the statue of Mahatma Gandhi during his visit to University of Papua New Guinea at Port Moresby in Papua. President addresses students at the university, also planted banyan sapling. Government has taken a number of steps to modernize Doordarshan news and entertainment channels by bringing in latest technology, strengthening regional bureaus and hiring fresh talent, said Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting Rajyavardhan Rathore in the Lok Sabha. Railway Ministry has decided to set up two new directorates tasked with increasing the speed of trains and boosting non-fare revenues. Advertising will also be its major job. The first directorate will identify and prioritize train corridors for raising the speed of trains. Today is the last date for filing nominations for 16th May single-phase assembly elections to Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry. Election Commission ordered imposition of prohibitory orders on poll days during the 5th and 6th phase voting in West Bengal to curb pre- and post-poll violence. A week after Bollywood superstar Salman Khan was named the Goodwill Ambassador for India at the Rio Olympics, the Indian Olympic Association has approached cricket legend Sachin Tendulkar and Olympic gold medalist Abhinav Bindra to be the country's brand ambassador at the Summer Games. The IOA is leaving no stone unturned to popularize and get funds for the Olympics. Ace Indian shuttler Saina Nehwal reached semi-final of the Asia Badminton Championship. She defeated third seed Chinese Shijian Wang 21-16, 21-19 in the quarterfinals.